With less than a year left on Umeme Limited's 20-year concession, the transition to government entity Uganda Electricity Distribution Company Limited has entered the final phase. Umeme was granted a 20-year concession to operate Uganda's low-voltage national grid on UEDCL's behalf in March 2005. Government in 2022 turned down Umeme's application for extension of the concession that is scheduled to end in March 2025. Since then, behind the scenes, preparations have been ongoing to ensure a smooth transition to UEDCL as a new operator.
We have now entered the 270 days to the end of the concession. And what's supposed to be happening those days, mainly to review the documents and the records. Those records include the staff, register, contracts, all the contracts that have been happening on the software and the hardware which they've been contracting. The objective of that is to engage those contracted third parties and see what has been the rights, obligation is as far as the business is concerned. Because we want to conclude those transactions 30 days before the end of the concession, such that if there's a need to transfer some contracts, it will be transferred to UEDCL as part of the distribution.
The transition from Umeme to UEDCL was one of the main topics of discussions at the recently concluded Power and Electricity Forum in Kampala. UEDCL is one of the successor companies that was established as a result of electricity reforms that culminated into the dissolution of the former Uganda Electricity Board. The company was established in 2001 to operate and manage the country's low-voltage electricity distribution network. At the time, Uganda's grid was highly depleted, resulting in high energy losses, inadequate investments, low revenue collection rates, among others. With the transition less than a year, Mwesiga also allayed fears that Umeme employees could lose their jobs when their employer's concession ends, explaining that they have repossessed similar concessions without any job losses.
All these staff have been operating this network. They have the qualifications, they have the skills and experience. So as we plan to increase the number of our employees, we shall consider all the staff. And we believe that their skills will be transferred to the benefit of the country and also for them to remain in employment. We don't project to have people losing their jobs, no, because this consolidation of the network is covering the entire country. So we are seeing broad expansion of activities, broad expansion of customer connections, expansion in the investment. And based on our investment portfolio, which is on an average of $70 million per annum, excluding new connections, because new connection only of 300,000 customers is budgeted at an average of 40 million customers. So in total, we shall be injecting $110 million per annum. That injection needs a lot of staff.
Discussions are currently ongoing to secure financing to invest in the grid and continue implementing the connection program in the aftermath of the transition.
We've engaged the Minister of Finance, Minister of Energy, as our policy makers. But at the same time, we have also engaged the regulator on as far as the ability of the tariff to manage our investment portfolio. And on the checklist, we've ticked up to 80%. So the 20% is now at a stage where the government, through means of finance, has invited for the financials, banks specifically, both commercial banks to provide short-term financing and development partners. Among the development partners, we're looking at African Development Bank, World Bank, and Exim of China. So the objective of that is to secure concession funding. So we believe by end of this month or next month, the Minister of Finance will be in a position to have done the evaluation, and we believe by September, the discussion about the specific terms and the condition will be done, especially for the short-term financing. Then long-term financing for development with the development partners will be going over even after the concession has come.
Sources say UEDCL has made an application to the Electricity Regulatory Authority to manage Umeme's territory post March 2025.